city of Lynchburg, Virginia at City Stadium. WHCS Channel 5 presents the 19th annual VHSCA East-West Football All-Star Game. I'm Tim Cole with Bob Hintz. Welcome to City Stadium in Lynchburg for the 19th annual meeting of these two teams. The series stands, Bob, 9-9. So tonight they play to break the tie.
This will be a great contest. The weather has broken. They thought it was going to get a lot of rain. It looks like the rain may hold off, but the weather is nice. It's not in the hot, humid like it was a couple years ago when we was up here, Tim. So this is going to be a great game. We got the best athletes in the state of Virginia, East versus the West.
Right now we are watching, as you see, well, there's the East squad, or at least a portion of it, a large portion of it, I might add. You're seeing the East squad player right now. They are, in fact, introducing the West squad players, and we may pick up, if we may, those introductions. Being introduced at the moment is Keith Lyle, number 33, a defensive back from G.C. Marshall High School. His coach is Dean Sisler. I'm going to do one, but then I'll let you do one. How does that
sound? Sounds good. James Quander is a defensive back from West Potomac High School, and his coach is Dan Mayer.
Chip Ferguson, number 40, a defensive end, 6'2", 205 from E.C. Glass High School, and his coach is Bo Henson. And along with each of these players are their parents and their respective coaches.
Sure is. And there you see number 41 as Anthony Merchant. He's a running back, 6 foot, 193 out of Lexington High School. His coach is Chuck Mars.
We're going to get into some history of the events here after we do these introductions. On the screen now is Stanley Ziegler, number 42. He's a 5'11", 240-pound fullback from Magna Vista High School, and Don Bateman is his coach.
He's a good-sized young man. And there's number 44, Felix Ado. He's also a running back. He's a short young man at 5'8", but he carries 185 pounds. He's from Lake Braddock High School, and his coach is Francis Dahl.
Brian Murphy, number 15, a center, 6'2", 220, from West Potomac High School. Again, Dan Mayer is his coach. Or Meyer, I guess it might be.
And there you see big number 54. That's Manson Clark. He is a tackle, 6 foot 270. He's a record-sized lad. He's from Rustburg High School, and his coach is Tom Gardner.
I'd like to see what the food bill for this week has been for these young men.
No thanks.
Keith Burns, number 55, a 6 foot 3 inch, 200-pound linebacker from T.C. Williams High School. Glenn Furman is his coach.
And there you see number 61, Reuben Brown. He is a tackle at 6'5", 278, also from East Glass High School, and his coach is Bo Henson. And you got 62.
Well, we got a number 60, and they had a name change there where they had just introduced 60. 61, that's the man on your screen right now is Reuben Brown.
Oh, sure is. I missed him. He's a young man out of E.C. Glass. Right. I don't know, have number 60 here, Tim.
Yeah, we didn't, neither one of us there. There's Todd Krickenberger. He's a guard, nose guard, 6 foot one, 230 pounds from Albemarle High School. John Mack is his coach.
And here you hear a crowd. We're on the west side. That's number 63, Vincent Guerrera, who plays guard and tackle. He's 6'2", 250 from Blacksburg High School, which is in this area, and his coach is Vaughn Phipps.
Again, we have a number change here, apparently, since we don't seem to have a number 64 on our roster. Bob, we apologize for not being able to correctly identify this young man. But proud to have him out here nonetheless. 65, which you see on your screen now, that is Chris Patton. He's a linebacker, 5'9", 190 from Graham High School. And Glenn Carlock is his coach.
And there's number 66, Michael W. Smith. He's 6 foot seven, 250, and he's a tackle from Covington High School, whose coach is John Woodzell.
And number 70 is Kevin E. Smith. He is a guard and tackle at 6'4", 248, Gate City High School. Nick Calabro is his coach.
Number 71, Chris Loftes. He plays tackle both offense and defense. He's 6'2", 220 from Hayfield Secondary High School. His coach is John Tompkins.
Number 72, Ron Wood, a 6'2", 250-pound guard from Yorktown High School. And Bruce Hansen is his coach. Now, that's not to be confused with York High School. This is Yorktown High School.
Right. There's number 75, Leslie Cash, who is a 6'6", 260-pound tackle, plays both offense and defense for Perry McClure High School. Bob Williams is his coach.
Number 77, Scott Witt, 6'6", 270-pound center from James Madison High School. Ned Garber is the coach.
And there's number 80, William Dysart, who's a defensive end at 6'2", 195 from Appalachia High School, whose coach is Tom L. Turner.
Number 81, David C. Wheeling, a tight end, 6'2", 235 from Salem High School. Willis White is the coach.
And there's number 88, Kevin Martin, who's tight end at 6'2", 225 from Annandale High School. Bob Hardage is his coach. And that's number 89 there.
That's in fact a change, a number change. That was originally listed as 82. That's Sean Wright, and he is a running back, defensive back, 6'1", 180 from Potomac High School. Bill Brown is the coach.
And there's 15, Troy Raines. He's from GW Danville High School, whose coach is Ed Martin. And if we got a chance, we can zip through the first few of those that we missed, Tim, if you want.
Sure, let's do that. Number 10 was Darnell White. He's a quarterback, 6 foot, 170 pounds from Jeb Stuart High School. Tom Earhart is his coach.
And number 11 is another quarterback. I'm sorry, he's a running back. That's Mike Wardall. He is 6'1", 180 from Potomac High School. Bill Brown is his coach.
We'll call him, I think that's Wardlaw.
Wardlaw, okay. I haven't got my reading glasses on. Help me out.
Number 12 was Jesse DeShazo. He is a quarterback, 6'2", 185 from Bassett High School. Jerry Kennedy was his coach.
Vincent Mayer is number 15. He's a wide receiver, 5'9", 145 from Alta Vista High School. Mickey Crouch is his coach.
And I think we caught up with them with Keith Hall, a running back from Powell Valley. Phil Robbins, the coach. Did we get everybody there?
I think we went down. We started with 30. Let's
30,
do number
okay.
22, Jerome Truzzell. He's a tailback, safety, 5'8", 175 from Blacksburg High School. His coach is Paul Boyer.
And Tracy Donegan, wide receiver and a defensive back, 5'11", 175 from EC Glass High School. Bo Henson, the coach. And then Charlie Garner, number 30, from Jeb Stuart High School, a 5'10 running back. Okay, I think we've got the West squad introduced. We want to tell you that you're going to be watching the finest high school athletes from the state of Virginia here as far as football is concerned. This is a week-long affair, and after the introduction of these players, we're going to give you a little information about this week-long camp here in Lynchburg.
Okay, Tim, while we're doing that, they've already started on the east side, so let's start with number 10, Andre Savage, who's a quarterback, 6'2", 187 out of Smithfield High School from down in the peninsula area. Miles Blount is his coach.
Sean Knight, number 11, quarterback, 5'9", 170 from Maury High School. And Bobby Pannenbach is his coach.
Number 12 is Kenneth W. Smith. He's a defensive back at 5'11", 180 out of Madison County High School. Eddie Dean is his coach.
Number 15, Cedric Gales, a defensive back, 5'8", 168, Central Lunenburg High School. Chippy Chappell is his coach.
I like that name, Chippy Chappell.
Is it Chippy? Or it might be Chippy Chappell. I'm not sure.
Well, whatever. Anyway, number 20 is Jerry German, who is a running back at 5'10", 177 out of Huguenot High School. His coach is Richard McPhee, and we have seen Richard McPhee before. In fact, I believe Richard was one of the coaches last year on the East team.
Sterling J. Branch, number 22, is a 5'11", 165-pound running back from King William High School. Roger Brooks, the coach.
At number 24, we have Brian Cully, who is a running back at 6'1", 170 out of Cortland High School. Ken Brown is his coach.
Leslie Hamlet, number 30, 5'10", 175, running back from Monacan High School. Buddy Gregory is the coach.
32 is Andrew Bell, who is a defensive back. He's 6'2", 192, Parkview High School. Ed Scott is his coach.
Number 33, Donald Robinson, defensive back, 6'3", 185, John Marshall High School. Lou Anderson, the coach.
At 35, we got Winchoss Hayes. Remember that name?
Yes, I sure do.
Linebacker, 5'11". He's 202 from Woodrow Wilson High School. And his coach is Darnell Moore. We had a chance to see him when they played Phoebus last year.
Yes, we did. Number 40, Chris Owens, a wide receiver from Lee Davis High School. Mac McConnell is the coach.
And at 41, we have Rodney Garrett. He's a defensive end, 6'3", 215 from Sussex Central High School. Dwight Reagan is his coach.
Tommy J. Morris, number 42, a defensive back, wide receiver, 5'11", 170 from Woodrow Wilson. Darnell Moore, the coach again.
I think I can get this one. Number 44, Dwayne Murphy, fullback, 5'8", 194 from Hampton High School on the peninsula. And the coach, Mike Smith, of course, is the coach.
We're almost caught up now. William Pritchard, number 50, is a 6'11"? Well, we're catching up with you. Our director is saying we're a little behind. We're trying to catch up here, Scotty, and what we've done is we've got William Pritchard, number 50, is a center from Thomas Dale. That's number 55 on your screen. Jeff Edmondson, he's a linebacker, 6'2", 212 from York High School. Bob Smith is his coach.
And Bob Smith's going to be at Denby High School next year. And there's number 60, Tyrone Scoggins. He's an offensive guard, 6'3", 238 from Chandler High School. Scott Miller is his coach.
61 is Jamie Terry. He's a guard slash tackle, 6'2", 240, Highland Springs High School, Ruby Ward. We missed one. I wanted to get back to Dilton Cotton, number 54, is a 6'2", 250 tackle, both offense and defense, from Granby High School, Dave Huddock. And I think that brings us up to date.
Okay, there we got number 62, Morris Hicks. He's an offensive guard, 6'2", 275, and of course he's from Phoebus High School. Coach Bill D is his coach.
And right after him, you just saw H.L. Carr, number 63, a 5'9 linebacker from Western Albemarle High School. Wayne Hepler is the coach.
And 64 is John Clevenger, who is a tackle at 6'5, 275 from Lee Davis High School. Mac McDonald is his coach.
I think we're finally caught up here. Here we go. There you see number 65, Leroy Lewis, a defensive end, 6'5", 220. John Marshall High School, Lou Anderson is his coach.
And there you see number 66 being introduced, Andrew Harvey. He plays tackle both offensive and defensively. He is 6'4", 252 from Henrico High School. John Trout is his coach.
That was not John Trout out there with him, though.
I know that.
Number 70 is Jonathan Palmore. He's a tackle and a center, 6'3". It's got to be 235. They got him listed as 135, but that, I guess that could be right. From Central Lunenburg High School, Chippy Chappell, the coach.
And there's number 71, Andy Miller, who is a tackle. He is 6'2", 220, First Colonial High School. Frank Webster is his coach. And there you got a big one.
Here's the little guy. This is John Labossier. He's a 6'3", 320-pound tackle from Cortland High School. Ken Brown, the coach.
And 75 right there on your screen is Ricky Carter. He's tackled both ways. He's 6'3", 225 from Sussex Central High School. Dwight Reagan is his coach.
Number 77, Jason Hull, a tackle both offense and defense. Mills Godwin High School, Ron Axel is the coach.
And there goes number 80, Timmy Bland. He's a running back and a wide receiver. 6 foot 185 from King George High School, Steve Hovac. is his coach. Sounds good to me.
81, another familiar name and face, Brian Gerzak, a linebacker, 6'3", 235 from Hampton High School. And Danny Mitchell was there with him as the coach, but, of course, Mike Smith is the head coach at Hampton High.
Right, and there's Mr. Jason Fry. He's a defensive end, 6'2", 210, Green Run High School. Elijah Harris is his coach. And you know this one.
Yeah, this one is another very familiar name and face. Aaron Monday, number 89, a tight end, 6'7", 230 from Hampton High School. Again, Mike Smith is his coach. That's Lanny Franklin, who is doing the honors, I understand.
And here's the other number 10. We have two number 10s on this team. This is Ryan Satchel. He's from Namanda High School, and his coach, Brett Betts, Coach Betts.
But not on the games.
Pardon?
Didn't bet on the games, does it?
I don't hope not. And then we can run down the coaches on both teams there, Tim, if you want.
All right, let's do that. We'll run down the coaches for the East squad that you just saw. However, we're going to hold off for just a second on that as the players now will make their way across the field to their respective benches. This is the 19th annual Virginia High School Coaches Association East-West All-Star Game. I'm Tim Cole with Bob Hintz, coming to you for our third year in a row from Lynchburg City Stadium. The East squad victorious the last two times. We've been good luck for the East squad.
Yes, we have.
They won 9-7 2 years ago and then won 33-18 last year in this annual classic from City Stadium. We're going to show you now the names of the East coaches, and they are Ron Axell from Mills Godwin High School, Ken Brown from Cortland High School, Chippy Chappell from Central Lunenburg High School, Eddie Dean from Madison County High School, Darnell Moore from Woodrow Wilson, and Littleton Parker from Southampton High School.
And then on the west side, let's see who we've got. That's the East coaches. We want the West coaches. That's all right. There they go. Bill Brown, Potomac Senior, Glenn Carlock from Graham High School. I got to get this far enough away from where I see it. David Chris from Blacksburg High School, Danny Mayer from West Potomac, Phil Robbins from Powell Valley, and Tom Turner from Appalachia High School. And these guys have been working real hard with these young men, and we're really looking forward to a good contest tonight.
The players now are going to get an opportunity to go to the sidelines and warm up again. They were out here every bit of 45 minutes ago, even maybe as long as an hour ago, and had gone through their warm-ups, and of course have had the occasion to cool down, and the last thing the coaches want, of course, is an injury to any of their players. So they're going to go through some of the warm-up drills, and we've got a feature we want to pass on to you. As soon as we're ready with that, we'll let you take a look at it. I was looking through the program here, a beautiful program put together for this Coaches Association All-Star Game. In the last 6 years, three of the MVPs have come from the Peninsula.
Well, I can believe that.
Yep, Linwood Lumpkins from Hampton High School in 85, then David Brown from Phoebus in 1988, and of course Eric Hunter, the quarterback for the East squad in 1989, leading that 33-18 victory.
And he had a tremendous game. We got a chance here before we go to that thing. I want to talk about some of the people from the Peninsula up here. The East trainer is Diane Limerick, who is also the trainer for the Hampton High School team. The program director is Lanny Franklin. The editor for the there's Dr. Don Musselman. We got the headshot of him. He's looking good.
That's, of course, the superintendent of the Hampton City Schools.
Right. I assumed everybody knew that.
Well,
I'm sorry.
A lot of people are going to see this that don't come from the Peninsula, see.
Right. Well, the editor for the program is Trish Mitchell. Football director, of course, is Danny Mitchell, one of the assistant coaches for the Hampton team. And the All-Star Games coordinator is Mike Smith, the head coach at Hampton High School. We also have an announcement to make that Trish Mitchell is the president-elect of the Virginia Coaches Association. I believe the first time a woman has been so honored at that position. If we get a chance, we're going to hope to get with Trish, and maybe we'll get an interview on her thoughts of getting that position.
We're having the captains meet in the center of the field for the East squad. They're represented by Andre Savage, number 10, by Sean Knight, number 11. 54 is
from the West, meet the captain
Yilton
from
Cotton
the East.
And Jeff Edmondson. And let's listen now as
Ron Cherry.
Referee Ron Cherry will give you the instructions.
Gentlemen, my name is Ron Cherry. I'm your referee this evening. I'd like to introduce at this time the other crew members. I have Mr. Toppings is the line judge, Mr. Brown is the back judge, Mr. Brothers, the head linesman, Mr. McCain is the umpire. Okay. What I have in my hand here, gentlemen, is a silver dollar. We're going to toss it. We'll allow the West to call. If it hits the ground, we'll call it in the air. If it hits, we'll repeat the toss, okay? He may call in the air, please.
Tails.
He called tails. It's heads. We've got the East winning. You want to receive. You're going to defend which goal, captains? You're going to kick this way, is that correct? Okay, man, if you would, turn your back to your respective goals, and I'll indicate to the press box. We've got the East winning the toss, electing to receive. Good luck to you. Shake hands, please.
Well, we appreciate Ron Cherry wearing. This is the second time in a year, in a row that his crew, who's over there from the southeastern region, that has been asked to come and do this All-Star game, and that's quite an honor. And he said last year it was an honor, and to do a repeat, I think this is the first time that's happened. And we appreciate it because he helps us. He takes the mic, and he really helps us out.
Just to refresh you, in high school football, you play four 12-minute quarters. The East squad will be in the red and white. The blue and white team, of course, the West squad. And we're about set to get this one underway from a very comfortably temperatured Lynchburg City Stadium. Most of the daytime, the last 3 days, I'm told the temperature has been in the upper 90s here. And I would say at game time, we're looking in the low 80s, maybe even upper 70s.
70s. Yeah, I would venture to say it's in the upper 70s. We'll pick up the starters as we go along. We don't have the starters, but we can sure pick them up as they go along, especially the quarterback and the running back and the wideouts. And we'll try to pick up the linemen as we go along, Tim.
Kicking off for the East squad will be Keith Burns, number 55. He's got the ball teed up. Back deep for the East squad is number 30, Leslie Hamlet.
And I believe that's number 80.
That's Tommy Bland from King George High School back at the other deep position. Ball is going to be taken by Bland at this 3-yard line. Comes loose, and West has recovered.
Well, that was a nice hit. Darned that ball loose, and he had no chance to get on the ball. A nice recovery. Looked like number 60 for the West. Recovered the ball, and that's the one young man we don't have a name for.
We'll call him the big gun right now.
Well, that's a big break for the West. You kick off, and you got fantastic field position down there on the 21-yard line, and we'll see the replay of this kickoff. Number 12, quarterback.
There you see the replay of the fumble and the recovery. Actually, it was not. Well, we're back to the live action now. It was not, in fact, number 60 that recovered that ball. It appeared to be number 75, which would be Leslie Cash. And then number 60 pounced on him and the ball.
Okay, that was Jesse Hall on the pitch out from the quarterback, one around the right side. It looks like he picked up maybe about 4 yards. 3 to 4 yards, and they're running a triple option, which is a tough thing to get into your players. It was only about a week of practice.
Stanley Ziegler right behind the quarterback. Picked up almost 6 yards on the play. Second down and about 4. DeShazo wants to pass. Ball is tipped and falls incomplete. The intended receiver was number 89, Sean Wright.
I didn't get the lineman who got a hand on that ball, but it was a good thing he did because the wideout had the inside position, and he was wide open for that pass. Maybe we can catch the hand.
That was one of the onrushing linemen there, yeah, that did tip that ball. We've got an official's timeout.
We have an equipment problem. And number 63 is replacing a young man. That's number 63. That's Vincent Guerrera that just went in.
He replaced Ron Wood for the West squad. And time is back in now with 10:47 remaining here in the first quarter. The West recovering the opening kickoff fumble and have the ball inside the East 20. Third down at about four. Handoff right side for close to enough for the first down. That was Keith Hall, number 20, getting the carry from Powell Valley High School.
Well, he was hit about three times, Tim, and did not come down until the third or fourth hit.
We'll have to see exactly where they mark his forward progress. Ron Cherry and his crew are on the far side of the field, and it would appear that they're going to, in fact, bring the chains across, and they are.
There's one, two hits, and he's still on his feet. It's the third and fourth man that finally brings him down. That was a great run by young Mr. Keith Hall, who was 5'10", 180, I'm sorry, 175.
And he was hit while he was out of bounds. Apparently, the ball, or rather the whistle had not blown, or there could have been a penalty on that call. It was close enough to the sidelines, but in his determination to make the first down, he just wouldn't go down, and it's going to come up a little short. It appears to be about a foot short of the first down. It'll bring up a fourth and a foot.
Well, they're going to try to draw him offside if they can, or maybe on a staggered count or a long count. But the cameraman needs to get off the field.
Our cameraman is right in the middle of the field. I think he better back up a little bit and get off the field in a hurry. This is getting a little bit too close to the action, I'm afraid.
Well, he figured if the chain gang can go out there, he can go out there. We have Todd Summer, who is helping the cameraman on the sideline. Todd was getting kind of anxious. I don't know if you saw that or not.
I was a little nervous myself. It's a fourth down and a foot to go. Deshae's other quarterback over center. Long count. Hand off to the big running back. Looks like he got the first down. It'll be very close.
It'll depend on where they spotted it. It looked like there was some movement in the interior up there, but I saw no flag. And they did give him the yardage for the first down, it looks like.
That was Stanley Ziegler, 5'11", 240 from Magna Vista High School. He's a real big, inside, at least in weight, running back. And now they signal a first down for the West squad. So the initial first down of the ball game, as the West squad has the ball, and it's inside the 12-yard line of the East squad. Mark it right about the 11.
Well, they started off at the 21, so they just did pick up enough yardage for that first down.
Chazo running to his left, throwing to his right in the end zone, touchdown!
Oh, nice catch. Defending on that play was number 42, Timmy Morse, out of Woodrow Wilson High School, but that was an excellent pass running to the left.
That was Tracy Donegan, number 24 from EC Glass High School, on the receiving end of that pass.
Watch this again. It's a nice rollout by the quarterback. He has to turn his shoulders. He does a good job, and a nice throw, Tim, right on the money. Nice try on the defensive by the defensive back, but it was a well-thrown ball.
Darnell White will try the extra point. Kick is up, it's long enough, and it's good. So with 10:07 remaining in the first quarter, the West squad is able to capitalize on a East fumble on the opening kickoff.
Well, this is kind of a rubber game in two different ways. Both teams have won nine games, but also up here this week, there were two basketball games, the East boys and the West boys and the girls. The West won both of those, while the East won the baseball contest and the softball contest. So this is sort of the rubber match for the East and West, besides also 1-9-9 on the series.
So the East squad now, trailing 7-0, will get the second kickoff. Took less than 2 minutes for the West squad to go down there and score that touchdown.
Well, when you start off with field position like on the 21, and you're really high from getting a fumble, it's hard to keep a team out. You really have to dig down deep and come up defensively. And of course, these young men have only been working together about a week, so it's you're going to have some holes in the defense and offense. Little timing.
DeShazo is bound for Virginia Tech. The young quarterback who threw that touchdown pass. This ball is fielded at the 1 yard line. Out across the 25 goes the ball carrier. That is Leslie Hamlet, number 30. I'll tell you a little more about DeShazo, and I'll move on to other things here. But His greatest moment in football was being selected to Faces in the Crowd in Sports Illustrated. He was also chosen as Offensive Player of the Year and Best All-Around Athlete.
So we have quarterbacking for the East, Sean Knight out of Maury High School. And of course on the wide out over in this side, big Aaron Mundy, number 89, is at the bottom of your screen.
Quarterback keeper on the rollout, he's got some running room. And he is knocked down as he crosses the 35-yard line.
That was Winchoss Hayes. I'm sorry, that was 35. That was James Quander, the defensive back, 6'4", 195 out of West Potomac, who made that tackle. And he turned him head over heels.
First down pickup on the carry. Sean Knight doing a good job of carrying the ball around the right side. And in motion to the left, handoff on the inside, Dwayne Murphy, and Murphy is stopped immediately by a good defensive effort.
That was a counter play. They got the flow, the offensive flow going to the left side, and Murray come back on a counter, but there was a good defensive play. I didn't see the tackler on that, but they got him right around the ankles.
Loss of about a yard on the play. Second down and 11 for the East, trailing 7-0.
Going right to the left, now at the top of your screen now is Aaron Mundy.
Again, Knight has the ball on the quarterback keeper, and he's going to be shy of the 40-yard line. Over there, among others, to make the stop were number 80, William Desart, number 80 Desart out of Appalachia High School.
Well, they only picked up about 2.5, maybe 3 yards at the most. I'll say it's 3rd and 8.
Get a chance to watch this again as the East squad will bring in Andre Savage at quarterback now from Smithfield High School.
It looks like they're rotating the wideouts and bringing a play in with the rideouts. I noticed that Mundy is in every other play.
And they do have a change of quarterback as well. Rolling to his left. Got a man open, hit him at the 47-yard line, a first down for the East squad if they mark his forward progress.
Well, he missed number 24. That young man, that's Brian Culley, right over the middle. There was nobody on him. I mean, he was so open, it was unreal. It was a missed coverage in there somewhere. Now watch, this a nice dropback by Andre Savage and a nice throw, but you can't see how open the young man in the middle was.
Good hit by the defense, but not before the first down is registered. As Ron Cherry, the referee, indicates a first down for the East, their second consecutive first down.
That was Anthony Merchant on the defender, the tackler on that play.
Ball on the East 47-yard line, first down. Mundy comes to the near side. Quarterback again has been changed to Sean Knight. Now Knight finds a receiver open at the 40-yard line, checked at the 35-yard line. And another first down as on the receiving end was Sterling Branch from King William High School.
Well, I don't know if that was the same play, but that was the man over the middle. There was the play was open, the play before he was wide open, and the coaches evidently picked that up. But that was a nice throw, a fake to a running back and then play action, man wide open over the middle.
You get a chance to see this again as Knight does a good job of squaring the shoulders and throwing accurately for the first down.
Again, you can see how open he was.
Savage is back at quarterback. He throws and a one-hopper. No, they say the catch off of the ground. The intended receiver was Chris Owens from Lee Davis High School.
Savage had a lot of pressure on him from the defense that time. It's a wonder he got the ball. He was right on the money, but he was short because he was really pressured.
So I guess that we can say a pattern has been established here, Bob. They are shuffling the quarterbacks on each and every play. And with that, Sean Knight returns to the lineup, a statistician's nightmare.
keep up with it.
Dwayne Murphy, the lone running back. Aaron Mundy to the near side, just at the bottom right hand of your screen. Quarterback still has the ball over the middle, got another man open, and a catch made at the 20-yard line. It'll be another first down.
Well, Tim, they are really watching Mundy. They're putting two men in his area on the zone, and that's opening up that pocket in the center. They're kind of worried about Aaron Mundy, which I would be too. It's 6'7", and as good a hands as he's got, and as fast as that young man is.
Here's a replay. Jerry German is the receiver on the play, and he is wide open at the 20-yard line. There you saw him. He fell down in an effort to catch the ball, but not before he registered the first down. So the East driving. And on an inside handoff, not much happening. So the East squad apparently throwing the ball because they have had some premonition that they're going to have difficulty running the ball.
Well, that was number 30 for the East that time that had the ball, Leslie Hamlet. And boy, he was met by two people at the line of scrimmage. He got nothing. In fact, I believe he may have lost a yard on that play.
Actually, he lost almost 2 yards. So it'll be second and 12 as the West defense now rises to the occasion. 6 minutes remaining in the first quarter. The West recovered a East fumble on the opening kickoff and took it in for the touchdown, and they lead 7-0. Hamlet comes in motion to the near side. Over the middle, complete to Aaron Monday at the 10-yard line. He's down inside the 10.
And that play is going to be open if they're trying to force him to go deep. He can go deep, but if you let him go across the center like that, nobody out there in the defensive secondary is big enough to handle him one-on-one.
There you see Aaron Monday trotting off the field. We'll watch the replay as Sean Knight is the quarterback of record on this play. And there you saw Aaron Monday with two defenders on him, but he was able to catch the ball with ease. And now Andre Savage returns a quarterback, gives to Dwayne Murphy. Murphy, a Hampton High School graduate, struggles to the 6-yard line.
All right, let's tighten up there.
So Murphy now, it'll be second down and goal for the East squad. Dwayne Murphy, of course, is headed for Virginia University. Murph was selected to the All-District, All-Peninsula, All-Region, and All-State teams. He played on two state championship teams and one state runner-up in his career. Dwayne Murphy, a winner. Second and goal for the East squad. Ball on the 5-yard line. Knight, the quarterback, has the ball, rolling to his right, gets away from one would-be tackler, now throws in the end zone for Monday, touchdown!
And we got a flag after the play. It looked like the quarterback was hit well outside, and you can see him coming back on. His jersey is half off, but Ron Cherry was right on top of that. But that was after the play, I believe. It will be a touchdown, if I'm not mistaken. Yes, it is a personal foul. And they will probably assess that on the kickoff, I would imagine, Tim.
Yeah, I believe you're right, Bob. I think they will. Here's the replay. There you saw Knight almost dragged down. He got away from him, and then you'll see him coming right towards you. There you saw he released the ball, and then he takes a hit and is shoved out of bounds, and I'm sure Ron Cherry is going to rule that that was unnecessary roughness on the quarterback.
Well, that way, and at the same time, you saw a nice catch by the premier tight end wideout for Hampton High School, football player, basketball player, baseball player. Young man can do it all.
Ron Cherry did not turn his mic on for us that time, so we did not hear what he said. He did indicate the touchdown would count, as we can tell.
But he put the penalty at on the extra point, so it will not be on the ensues.
I have a dead ball, personal foul, against the defense. TD count.
So he did not explain how the penalty would be assessed, if at all. I have a feeling.
But he did step it off, Tim. I watched him step the ball off, okay. So it looks like to me. I'm assuming he did, unless there's not a mark for the PAT line.
The extra point kick is up, and they're ruling it's no good, wide to the left. So the kicker, Jason Hall, number 77, misses to the left, and it will remain at 7-6 in favor of the West squad. 4:42 remaining here in the first quarter. We've had a lot of offense already. I was surprised to see the offense for the East squad so fluid. I mean, they really didn't miss a beat. They couldn't run very well, but they sure did pass.
But what's really surprising is both of those quarterbacks threw the ball equally as well. I mean, I was had not picked it up until just before you mentioned that there was a different quarterback in there. I saw they was rotating the receivers, but they're also rotating the quarterbacks. They, of course, being the East coaches, which is Ron Axel is the head coach over there.
The East squad on a two-game win streak. They won 9-7 in 88 and 33-18 last year, led by Eric Hunter, who has moved on to Purdue University and started several games at quarterback as a freshman and is the heir apparent to the starting job here as a sophomore for Purdue in the fall. It'll be with great enjoyment we watch his progress through the college ranks. Hull has the kickoff in the air, taken at the 9-yard line. That's Charlie Gardner, number 30. Gardner has some running room out across the 30 to the 32-yard line.
That was a nice run back. He went over, there was a run back to the right side, and he had a nice wall over there.
Darnell White will be the quarterback for the West squad. And now we've got an official's timeout. Wait and see what this is. I don't think we have any TV timeouts for us tonight. We don't need any. I believe they had a bit of a problem here with the chain. It looks like they've got that problem almost cleared up. And they do. So we'll crank the clock up with 4.5 minutes remaining in the first quarter. The West squad with the ball at their 32-yard line, first and 10. Count from White. Pitch back. This is Garner.
And number 81, Brian Gerzak, was over there to finish off that run, but they have noticed that the West have run, their running plays have been to the right side. I don't think they have run anything to the left except that rollout on the touchdown pass.
Sean Wright from Potomac High School brings the play in to the quarterback, Darnell White. You see Mike Smith on the sidelines among other coaches. I might add that Mike is not coaching.
He's the director for all the All-Star contests here today.
Inside handoff for the West squad. Not much happening there as the West having some difficult running as well.
That was Delton Cotton, 6'2", 255 from Granby High School, who was right in the middle of that. Neither team is having much success up the middle. The West is having more success around the right, around doing wide things. They came out the first play, they ran the triple option, but I haven't seen it since.
Troy Raines and Tracy Donegan come to the near side, lined up as wide receivers. Third down and 6 for the West. Again, a long count from Darnell White, rolling to his left, still has the football. Being chased by big number 66, gets away from him, stays in bounds, and gets close to the first down.
That was Brian Gerzak, number 81, on the tackle, but he outran the defenders, well, he being the quarterback.
That was Andrew Harvey from Henrico High School, number 66, 6'4", 252, and his White's quickness got him the first down on that.
Oh, sure did. He had two young men that was breathing down hard on him, as you'll see here on the replay, and there he just outruns number 66 and number 88, both from the east. He just outran them.
So good job by Darnell White to get the first down for the West. Ball is at the West 44. 2:50 remaining here in the first quarter. Pitch comes to Charlie Gardner. Nice move. Oh, an excellent move. He's still on his feet. He may go all the way. And he will.
There were some missed tackles there, and that'll really make the East squad very upset, the coaches on the East side, because he should have been stopped about 4 different times. There's some missed tackles. You can't tackle these young men with their arms. You have to get down and get them. Watch the replay, Tim. There's one he ran out of. There's another he ran out of, and then he just outran. Nice cutback. Beautiful job by number 30 there, Charlie Gardner.
Don Robinson, number 33, was the last East man to have a shot at him, and he just sidestepped him like he wasn't anything at all. So Gardner has impressed the crowd here. The West is adding to their lead, and the kick is up, and it's good.
Well, Tim, remember I was telling you that they were running everything to the right except the quarterback rollout? Well, that was one time they went to the left, and it was an excellent. And how long was that run?
That was a 56-yard run. So Charlie Gardner, number 30 from Jeb Stuart High School, has lit up the board here with a 56-yarder. making some excellent moves. There you see him getting congratulations from his teammate on the sideline here on the near side. Fine effort by Mr. Garner. So we've seen some explosions here in the first quarter. We're always happy to see this kind of game, at least I am.
Well, it's good for the crowd because you'd hate to just to see three downs and a kick and three downs and a kick. We've got some great offensive and defensive specialists out here.
Keith Burns has the ball teed up with 2:37 remaining here in the first quarter. West squad with a 14-6 score. This was taken by Hamlet again. Leslie Hamlet finds a hole all the way out across the 40 to the 42-yard line.
Well, he did a good job breaking through the wedge. He had a nice wedge of about five blockers in front of him, and he just popped right through there and almost broke it. Well, that would have electrified this crowd.
He had one man to beat, and of course he took him on head up. We'll see it on the replay.
And you can see that wedge right in front of him there, just to the top of your screen, and there he breaks right through it. Did a great job, but the safety man back did his job.
And Dwayne Murphy is wrestled to the ground after no gain.
A big number, 64 for the West, and that's another young man I don't have a number for.
Well, I found out we had a name switch on him. That's Bill Swarm. He's a defensive end from G.C. Marshall High School. 6'4", 215.
Well, I knew if anybody had it, you had it.
We have to thank Lanny Franklin for all of his help.
Oh, yeah, he really did. They had a lot of changes in the program, and Lanny brought us up most of the updates, and we really appreciate that.
Gain of about a yard on the play, second down and nine. On the quarterback option, pitch goes back to number 20, Jerry German from Huguenot High School, and he is driven out of bounds, but not before he gets out to the 48-yard line.
He's going to be about four yards short of the first down, three or four, depending on where they mark it.
Clock stopped with the out-of-bounds play with a minute 31 remaining in the first quarter. We get a chance to watch it again. Here you see on the quarterback option, this is Sean Knight, the quarterback, pitching back to German. And then he is driven out of bounds by number 60 for the West squad. The mysterious number 60, we still don't know what his name is. Savage back at quarterback, has a man open at the 40-yard line, completes the pass for the first down.
And he was well covered that time by number 41, that's Anthony Merchant, but nice pass. Nice and low right at the belt line, impossible for a defender to get in and knock it away without causing a foul of interference.
That was Brian Cully. As you watch the replay, there you see the tackle being made by Merchant. But Cully got the first down for the East squad. He's from Cortland High School. First down at the West 39-yard line. And Sean Knight is the quarterback. Hand off Dwayne Murphy. Finally gets some running room, as we so many times saw as we covered Hampton High School football this past fall. Dwayne Murphy breaks into the open for another big gainer down to the 22-yard line.
You will see a lot of times he'll pick up one and two, maybe lose a couple yards, and all of a sudden, boom, he squirts through. That was an excellent play call by the offensive coordinator over there with the East squad. And you can see he just popped through and almost outran the pursuit.
You're only going to hold Murphy down for a few times. You're not going to keep him down all night. We've seen that time and again. Hamlet comes in motion to the near side. Ball pops up and is jumped on by Dwayne Murphy. And in fact, he recovered the fumble as the ground is a little wet. It's a little damp from rain that occurred earlier in the afternoon. We're happy to say that the rain has stopped, and it appears that we're going to have a perfect evening for football. Temperature in the mid to upper 70s. After a high during the daytime of the mid to upper 90s, so a pleasant change, I might add.
Yes,
a comfortable
yes.
breeze out here tonight. I know these young men in these full uniforms are happy to see the playing conditions the way they are. There you see the West sideline. Second down and 10, and now we've got
the end of the quarter, Tim.
The end of the quarter. All right, so we've played 12 minutes here from City Stadium in Lynchburg, Virginia. And after 12 minutes, the West squad leads 14-6.
And that was on that one turnover on the opening kickoff with the fumble at the 21-yard line, and then they took it in from the 21 in just about 2 minutes and made the score.
Just to recap for you very quickly, to emphasize what you said, Bob, the West squad did recover the opening kickoff fumble, and Donegan was the receiving end of a 11-yard TD pass for the West squad from Darnell White. And that made it 7-0 with the PAT good, with 10:07 to go in the first quarter. Then Aaron Monday scored on a 5-yard pass from Knight to make it 7-6 as the extra point was no good, with 4:42 remaining in the first. And then with 2:37 remaining, Garner, number 30 for the West squad, raced 56 yards for the touchdown. The extra point was good, and that's the way we stand now as we begin the second quarter. The West squad leading 14-6. At some point in time when we have the opportunity, I would assume at halftime, after you've had a chance to talk with, I believe we're going to try and get Gannon Baker over here,
yes,
the young man from Hampton High School who's Duquesne College bound.
And he was playing in the East basketball all-star game.
We're going to get a chance to have a word or two with young Gannon Baker from Hampton High School, and hopefully we'll get Trish Mitchell, who, as we mentioned at the top of the program, has been elected as the chairman.
No, president-elect.
President, excuse me.
President. President-elect of the Virginia Coaches Association.
Trish Mitchell, of course, the athletic director at Hampton High School. So the East squad has the ball to start the second quarter. They have the ball at the 22-yard line. Pitch goes to the man in motion. That's Sterling Branch. He is driven out of bounds inside the 20. Sterling Branch from King William High School. He's 5'11", 165-pounder.
Well, brings up third and long, third and five. And you got your big Mr. Mundy in there. You can, if you're the West, you're going to be looking for a pass.
Wide receiver to the right is Tommy Bland, and Mundy comes wide to the left.
Draw wouldn't be a bad call right now.
Andre Savage, the quarterback, with one lone setback. Savage looking for Mundy all the way. Mundy had it and couldn't hold on to it as he was hit immediately by Anthony Merchant, number 41 from Lexington High School. And Mundy would have normally had that ball. He just never could quite get his hands on it.
Well, it was a little bit behind him, not much, but just a little bit over his right shoulder, and he was running across the field. But that was a great defensive play. In fact, he turned Aaron all the way around.
He really did. Merchant did a good job on defense that time, and it brings up a fourth down and five for the East squad, and they are going for it. They send three receivers to the right side, again with a lone setback, and one receiver to the left. That is Kenneth Smith. Pressure from the West squad. That's going to give the ball over to the West, as the ball will go over on downs. In there for the West squad, number 64 and number 71, Chris Loftes. They smothered the quarterback from the East, and no chance at all. So the West squad holds on downs.
Well, that was a big loss. He started at the 22 and ended back at about the 28, so he lost about 5 yards.
Was Sean Knight, who was the quarterback for the East squad on that play. So with 11 and a half remaining in the first half, the West squad, leading by eight, takes over at their 26-yard line.
And there was a fumble in the exchange, but West ended up with it. The quarterback got a handle on it. That ball must be a little bit slippery, Tim. I know the grass is a little slippery. I was out there earlier talking to Danny Mitchell, and the grass had a heavy dew on it, so I'm sure the ball is, it's hard to keep the ball dry.
That is DeShazo, the quarterback. You see the ball pop up. He did a good job just getting control of the ball after the ball was loose. So a loss on the play of about a yard and a half. Call it second down and 11 for the West. They lead 14-6. I'm Tim Cole with Bob Hintz, coming to you from Lynchburg Stadium in Lynchburg, Virginia. 19th annual Virginia High School Coaches Association. Little flip pass over the middle, almost picked off. as getting a hand on it and almost coming up with the ball was Jeff Edmison. He's from York High School.
And that was Bob Schmidt, who coached him at York High School, which was Bob's last year at York. He is going to Denby High School on the peninsula and the AAA next year. And Bob is excellent, does an excellent job out there at York, so they look great things for him at Denby High School. As you can see the replay of that last play.
Edmiston couldn't come up with it. The ball goes incomplete, stopping the clock with 10:36 remaining in the first half. And it's third down and 12 for the West. DeShazo rolling, gets some pressure, steps away from a couple of would-be tacklers, now squares and throws. Way downfield, he's got it! Inside the 40-yard line! And it's a first down. What a spectacular pass and catch.
Well, I'll tell you what, I am really impressed with number 12, Jesse, was that DeShazo?
DeShazo.
DeShazo. He runs to the left and throws the ball as well as any quarterback I've seen in high school in a long time. Eric Hunter could do that, but you can see he's running to his left and is hurried a little bit, has to square his shoulders way and throws a bullet right on the money.
Excellent pass and catch. That was Sean Wright on the receiving end. DeShazo is bound for Virginia Tech. First down for the West squad. The crowd's still buzzing here. 39-yard line is the line of scrimmage. And stacked up is Keith Hall after a gain of a yard or so. East squad must be a little frustrated after that last play. They had a third down and long and put good pressure on DeShazo, but he was able to unload and get the completion.
Well, he's a good scrambling quarterback, but he keeps his head about him and his eyes open and looking downfield for his receivers. And that's something that's hard to teach.
Stanley Ziegler right behind DeShazo, and Ziegler is faked to. The pitch goes to the outside man, and the East defense is ready and waiting for Keith Hall. Over there, stop for the East, Donald Robinson, number 33, along with 55, again, Jeff Edmiston, and also on the play, number 63, H.L. Carr from Western Albemarle High School.
Well, he didn't pick up anything. They still got third and long, again a third and long, so you can look for the West if they hold true to form to have the quarterback roll to the left and look downfield for one of his receivers.
37-yard line of the East. Third down and nine. DeShazo gets pressure, and this time will be sacked back at midfield.
Big number 77 that time for the East.
That's Jason Hull.
He's out of Mills Godwin High School. Did a great job. He just went in his area, took his normal run, put pressure, and the quarterback rolled right to him.
Also over there was Jason Fry from Green Run High School. Back to the 49-yard line. Fourth down and almost 20. You know, speaking of Green Run, August 31st, first high school game of the season, Hampton High School hosting the Green Run Stallions at Darling Stadium. Hope you'll be there for that. We will be bringing that game to you on delayed tape. Here on Channel 5, fair catch call for and taken at the 13-yard line. The East squad, man back was Andrew Bell, number 32 from Parkview High School. Getting excited about the upcoming high school season, Bob. We've got some great games with Peninsula District teams playing each other, as well as some inter-peninsula and out-of-the-area games. This Hampton Green Run game should be a real good ball game.
Oh, it really will be. There's going to be some great teams on the peninsula. We see Hampton is probably going to be picked one of the top teams again. Kickatan is, Kirk Newsom does an excellent job. Bill D has got a good group coming back. Of course, Coach Kyle's over Bethel always does well. And I believe Denby may be a little force to be reckoned with the Bob Schmidt up there. So the Peninsula District's going to be real stocked with some good football players and has a new addition this year too, Tim, in Gloucester High School moves to the Peninsula, coming from AA to AAA.
Dwayne Murphy gets the call for the East squad as they pick up a couple of yards. Second down and about eight for the East. 7:55 remaining here in the first half. The West squad jumped on top and have never trailed. They lead 14-6. Trying to break a two-game winning streak by the East squad. There you see some of the coaches on the west sidelines. Quarterback this time is Andre Savage from Smithfield High School. Hand off to the man in motion, and he is tripped up. Jerry German is pitched up. Okay, we'll return to City Stadium here in Lynchburg right after this brief timeout. Third down and about 10 yards to go for the East squad. 6:50 remaining in the first half. Again, they faked this play this time, and the pass is going to be a little too long. Dwayne Murphy well covered on the play. Over on the defense was Keith Lyle, number 33 out of G.C. Marshall High School, right on top of Dwayne Murphy, but certainly not illegally, but he was right there.
No, he had him covered pretty well. This is the first time we've had a punt situation be the first punt of the ball game.
Get a chance to watch a replay of this last action here. They faked the inside handoff to German. And then Dwayne Murphy, there you see Murphy shadowed well by the West defender. So going back in deep punt formation will be Brian Cully, number 24 of Cortland High School, standing at his end zone, right at the goal line. Absolutely no rush by the West squad. He gets a good end-over-end kick. It hits at the 50-yard line and then takes a West roll where it's covered by the East squad.
Well, that was real smart on the West. Stay away from the ball. Don't even try to catch it. It's not going to go very far in that wet, soggy field. It's just going to kind of die. In fact, it did bounce back and gave him a couple more yards.
I think I've hit a golf shot like that before, where the ball just hit and dug in and didn't go anywhere. Actually spun backwards. So the West, with good field position, will start from the East 48-yard line, leading by 8 with 6:23 remaining here in the first half. 19th annual East-West All-Star Game from Lynchburg's City Stadium in Lynchburg, Virginia, on a cool, and I mean cool, July 12th, 1990. Not much happening as the East defensive squad is waiting for the run by Charlie Garner this time. Garner broke 156 yards for a touchdown in the first quarter.
Well, he made a couple people miss at close quarters. He's got real quick feet. He's only 5'10", 165, but he has really got quick feet.
Well, we watch the replay. Let me tell you, he's undecided where he may be going to his college. He enjoys weightlifting, horse riding, and music. His fondest memory in athletics is being chosen to the All-State team 2 years in a row, and he certainly showed why he would be with that fine effort earlier in the ballgame. Inside of 5.5 minutes to go. Second down and 10, no gain on the play. Long count again by the West quarterback. That is Darnell White. Rolling, throws, got a man wide open at the 35-yard line, still on his feet, and finally driven out of bounds by Brian Gerzak and others. Couldn't get that one out.
Well, that young man did a great job of waiting for his receiver to get in the zone that was open right behind the linebacker that time. And he was wide open. Just a nice little touch on a pass. What a nice touch the young man has. Watch this replay.
You can see he had plenty of time and just lofted the ball nice and softly into the hands of the receiver. An excellent job.
That's a hard pass to throw, especially rolling to your left.
That's Kevin Martin, who was on the receiving end. Another first down for the West. Inside handoff, not much happening there.
That was number 54. That's Dalton Cotton along with Brian Gerzak that time on the stop. I didn't get the third player was involved in that.
Felix Addo, number 44 from Lake Braddock High School, was the ball carrier, 5'8", 185, and he got nothing. So the ground game just is not working very well for either squad. The East has had a little bit of success, and of course with that exception of the 56-yarder by Garner, the West has really had little success with it also. If you can get a 56-yarder every now and then, you don't mind.
That's right. It really boasts your yard per play.
This is Garner again. And again, he shows good moves as he picks up a few yards. Going to give him progress of about 4 yards.
And that looked like Andre Savage, number 10, was the... Now, he's a quarterback. It may be Ryan Satchel was the defender at that time. That may be who was defending out there because that was the East player. And we got two number 10s.
Here's a replay on the delayed handoff to Garner. Look at there, he made a nice move, a spinning move. As you said, I believe you're right on that. I think we're looking at Ryan Satchel on the defense that time. Third down and about six for the West. Fumble on the exchange, the ball is loose, is picked up, and getting pretty good yardage, it'll be close to a first down. I believe he's going to be a little short of the first down.
Well, that's a dangerous thing to do. When that ball is down there and you've been down to pick it up, that gives the defense a chance to dive for it, knock you out of the way. Normally what the coaches would rather have you do is just drop down and recover the ball, but you can just see, just pick that thing right up right away for number 41. Anthony Merchant was diving for the ball.
Darnell White made a gainer out of what was an apparent big loser, and he almost got the first down. Now the West has called a timeout with a fourth down and about 2 yards to go. 2:53 remaining here in the first half. And they want to discuss this with the coaching staff to find out exactly what they're going to do. They do have a breeze to their back in the event that they do have a field goal kicker, and we're not particularly aware of what type of kicking game we're going to be looking at, but I see what would appear to be a kicking team coming on. Number 75, Leslie Cash, has come on the field, among others. I'm not sure Cash is the field goal kicker, if that's what they're going to do.
Well, the ball is spotted at, where's that, at the 20? Right at the 20-yard line. So if he kicks a field goal, that's going to be 37 yarders.
I don't think they're going to kick. I just think they may have brought in a different unit to go for the first down on fourth down.
Yeah, I believe you're right.
They brought some new people in, which led you to believe they might be going to kick.
And they're playing. They got an unbalance to the left.
Darnell White is the quarterback. The East squad telling themselves, do not jump off. Don't let that long count pull you off. And the handoff goes, it'll be, again, I think, short of the first down.
Well, that was number 75. The first man in there was Ricky Carter. He's a tackle out of Sussex Central High School, 6'3", 225, and he was the first man on the ball carrier.
Let's give him credit for preventing the first down as the East will take over on downs as Charlie Gardner was unable to pick up the 2 yards. And so that will give the ball over to the East squad. I understand, I hope our fans will stay tuned as at halftime, right at the conclusion of the first half, you're gonna have an opportunity to talk with Gannon Baker, the outstanding basketball player from Hampton High School who's going on to Duquesne College this fall. And we'll have an interview with him momentarily at the conclusion of the first half. I understand he was down there earning some money to go to college selling t-shirts. I'm just joking about that. He was helping out here at All-Star Week as he was working at one of the concession stands. These young men really enjoy themselves at this particular All-Star break. They get a chance to come up here to Lynchburg and make new friends and learn a few things about football they may not have already known and make some friendships they may keep for a long time. We're inside of 2 minutes now in the first half. East squad trailing by 8. Of course, I remind you, in high school ball, you have that two-point option. Struggling for yardage is Sean Knight, the 5'9", 170-pound quarterback from Maury High School. We get a chance to watch a replay of that last action as Knight tries to go to the right side and steps inside of one would-be tackler. Looks like he's down there, but his determination gets him about 3 or 4 more yards. So excellent effort, and it'll be close enough to measure for the first down.
Well, the field position they have, Tim, with 1:31 to go in the first half, I don't look for him to do anything. There's 1:31 left to go in the first half, so I don't look for him to do anything silly. I've got the portable mic. I'm going to go down with Gannon Baker. We're going to do an interview down here.
You may need to have them turn that one on because it's not coming through. They want to check and see if it's on.
Is it on now?
Now it's on.
Now it's on. Okay.
I can hear you fine now.
All right. I was hearing you good all the time. Of course, I don't need a microphone for that.
So the measurement shows the East squad a yard short of the first down. Third down and a yard. inside of a minute and a half to go. And the quick hitter, well, the quarterback still has the football, and it looks like he'll end up with a loss. It looked like he had a first down, but he, in fact, never handed the ball off and then was thrown for a loss. Now the West squad is going to take a timeout to reserve as much time as they can on the clock here.
Well, they're going to have to punt. They being the East team, and that'll give the good field position to the West. And their quarterbacks, both quarterbacks, have been doing a good job.
So a minute and 4 seconds remain here in the first half. If you joined us late, you're watching the 19th annual coaches, I should say the Virginia coaches. I'll try this again. Virginia High School Coaches Association. The VHSCA 19th Annual East-West All-Star Game. The East and the West for this week are at a 2-2 tie as far as the events are concerned. This would break the tie. If I remember correctly, last year the same thing applied. I believe the football game was going to determine which of the squads, East versus West, won the overall week. There you see the replay. And a good effort on the defense by that time from Chip Ferguson of E.C. Glass High School. E.C. Glass has put out a few winners in their years of...
Oh, they most certainly have.
104 remaining.
One of the very successful Hampton High School coaches, Johnny Palmer, left Hampton High School and went to E.C. Glass and did a great job coaching up there for many years.
You regular Channel 5 viewers, and I say Channel 5, we used to be Channel 29, but now for the fall and forever, as far as I know, you'll watch the best in local high school sports on Channel 5 WHCS, and we'll have our full-scale schedule of football games that's coming up in this fall. First game will be August 31st, Hampton hosting Green Run High School, and we'll have that game for you. Fine kick into the wind, taken at the 44-yard line, trying to get out of bounds. And trying to get yardage, still on his feet. Tracy Donegan finally is wrestled out of bounds. But not before he gets excellent field position at the 31-yard line. But they marked the ball between the 32 and the 31-yard line, so the strategy of the West squad pays off as they call a timeout to reserve some time. They've got 49 seconds remaining in the first half. And they'll have four downs to work with. Quarterback now is Jesse DeShazo. Stanley Ziegler, one of the running backs. DeShazo still has the ball. Again, rolling to his left, throwing to his right, which is the most difficult thing to do. And the ball comes up short with 41 seconds remaining in the first half. DeShazo rolling to his left, and that's, you know, if you've ever tried to do this before, it's very difficult to do, especially when you have two very large and quick defenders breathing down your neck. To roll to your left and then throw back as a right-hander. As Bob mentioned a little earlier, one of the finest in the Peninsula District to ever do so was Eric Hunter. He had that ability to succeed in that area. The officials time out here as a piece of equipment was on the field. Ron Cherry stopped the clock. Actually, he stopped the count as the clock had been stopped with the out-of-bounds play. 41 seconds remaining, second down and 10 for the West. They have led from the very beginning as they recovered an opening East fumble on the opening kickoff and drove in for the touchdown. DeShazo taking a deep drop, and now he is sacked at the 48-yard line, and a face mask call probably forthcoming as a flag went down very quickly. Back on the defender was Rodney Garrett of the East, and he got a hold of the quarterback. Unfortunately for the East, it appeared that he may have gotten the face mask as well.
Well, Tim, he did get a face mask. I'm right down here on the sideline, and he got a big hunk of that face mask.
So the loss will stand, but the yardage will be marked off against the East. Here we will see now, DeShazo gets in trouble, and he's got him, and he's also got that face mask, and Ron Cherry right on top of the play throws the flag without hesitation. There was no question that a face mask call was forthcoming. So that would be a dead ball foul, I would assume.
Defense, replay second.
So they replay the down. have heard the last part of that description by referee Ron Cherry. Clock has restarted with 27 seconds and counting. You see a good look at the quarterback, DeShazo. Fakes the handoff, still has the football, wants to run the ball, he does, looks downfield, now he has to carry the ball as he is well beyond the line of scrimmage. He picks up good yardage for the West squad and of course stops the clock with 7 seconds remaining. Quite a few of these young men are undecided as to where they're going to play college ball if they play at all. Here you'll get a chance to watch the replay. DeShazo, as I mentioned earlier several times, is headed for Virginia Tech. You see DeShazo fake the pump to hopefully freeze the defender. That's Brian Gerzak of Hampton, number 81, who chases him out of bounds. But not before DeShazo picks up a first down. And now with just 7 seconds remaining, we're going to see an apparent field goal attempt. This one will be from the 27-yard line, a 37-yard attempt. It appears to be long enough, and it's good. So a 37-yarder from Ricky Webb. Now check that, number 10 is Darnell White. So the West squad is able to pad their lead with just 2 seconds remaining. And they now lead 17-6, as there will be just enough time for the East squad to receive the kickoff. And again, we invite you to stay tuned at the immediate conclusion of the first half, as we'll go down to the sidelines, and Bob Hintz will have an opportunity to talk with Gannon Baker. Those of you from the peninsula are very familiar with Gannon's successes at Hampton High School. Of course, his father was a basketball player at Hampton High School as well, Arnie Baker, and has been very instrumental in Gannon's development as a superb ball handler and good point guard. So the West squad comes up and they do a great job of getting the first down. Give DeShazo credit for an excellent job of scrambling the ball, getting a first down, and then Darnell White, who has been alternating series with DeShazo at quarterback, booted a 37-yard field goal and gives the East squad a 17-6 lead with just 2 seconds remaining here in the first half. Keith Burns kicks off. The ball stops dead and is finally recovered by the East squad. And that is your half. So we have played 24 minutes and the West squad leads 17-6. Let's go down to the sidelines now. And Bob Hintz, who has Gannon Baker alongside, we'll wait for just a minute so we can get a camera on Bob and Gannon. We know where you are, Bob. We just can't get the cameraman to know where you are.
Case, our we're going to have a camera here in a second, Tim.
Yeah, I was going to say, you go ahead and start talking with Gannon if you want while we try and set up that the video portion of this, as Bob has got a nice-looking knees on you there, Hintz. Where'd you get those good-looking kneecaps?
Well, while he's setting up, I'm going to go ahead and start. I got Gannon Baker here. Of course, Gannon is a graduate of Hampton High School, and congratulations for being selected on the All-Star team, and the game was played a couple nights ago. Tell me a little bit about that game, Gannon.
Oh, thanks a lot. It's an honor to be selected, and it was a very good game. The West, they rebounded better than us, and their second team played a little bit better than our second team. I think that was the difference in the ball game. But I was pleased by the way we played overall. And, you know, it's an all-star game, and sometimes you win, sometimes you lose.
Well, that's true. Well, you know, we were talking earlier that the both basketball games were won by the West. The softball and baseball game was won by the East. So this is kind of a rubber match in this football game.
Right.
Tell me a little bit about going to college next year, going to Duquesne.
I'm looking forward to it. I've been working real hard over the summer. And the situation up at Duquesne, it looks very good right now. They have a senior point guard ahead of me, so I'm looking to get my feet wet the first year, maybe start by my sophomore year.
Well, it gives you a year to learn their system, too, which
exactly.
Has got to be good. Tell me what they sent for you to work with during the summer. You and I were talking earlier a bit about it.
They sent me a good weight program to get on, and they sent me a lot of drills to do, and I work out a lot on my own, so I use those.
Well, that's great. Are you going to take a couple weeks off and then go back? What's on for the rest of the summer?
Yes, I've been working very hard on my own, and I think now it's time to take a few weeks off. My best friend Danny and I are going to go to the Virginia Beach and relax a little bit, and 2 weeks from now I'll start all over again, and maybe it'll help me when I get there at Duquesne.
When do you report?
Orientation is August 22nd.
Well, so that's not just right around the corner.
Right, exactly.
Well, listen, congratulations. We enjoyed watching you this year, and we're going to miss you, and we'll try to keep up with you at Duquesne next year.
I appreciate that.
Good enough. Tim, let's go back up to you.
All right, by passing my congratulations to Gannett as well, as he did a great job for Hampton High School this past season, and we wish him all the great success at Duquesne College, and we are quite sure that he'll do very well there. All right, our halftime score, the West squad leading 17-6. We'll return with the second half of action, but first let's take a brief timeout. The teams have returned here to City Stadium in Lynchburg, Virginia. I'm Tim Cole with Bob Hintz, and we are moments away from the start of the second half of this 19th annual East-West All-Star Game. And Bob, your thoughts on the first half?
Well, I thought there was a whole... my perspective was that there was a lot more offense than I expected scoring-wise. I thought they might move the ball up and down the field, but the defense would... stiffen up a little bit and stop some drives, but there was a couple of key plays in that, especially for the West. They scored with 2 seconds to go and a field goal from where I was standing down there with Gannon Baker on the sideline. It looked like to me that the ball was real low, and I couldn't tell whether it went over or under the crossbar. And of course they got the turnover right at the beginning of the game, gave them great field position, so they got an early 7 points. But it's been uphill for the East squad ever since that way. But I'm surprised about the rotation of the quarterbacks. Every play, the East brings in a different quarterback, which is very unusual. Last year we saw where one quarterback would run one series and then the next quarterback would run the next series. But it's when you have athletes of this caliber, Tim, you're going to have some good football.
Well, exactly what's happening is the East squad is doing, as you say, alternating every play at quarterback, while the West squad is alternating series.
Right.
DeShazo goes in one series, and then Darnell White will go in another. So the West squad is doing with the more conventional rotation, but like you said, it's working pretty well for the East. The East has moved the ball well in the air. Neither team has been particularly successful on the ground, with that very marked exception, the 56-yard run by Garner as he broke tackle after tackle and then just scampered down the left sideline and broke into the clear.
And Dwayne Murphy had a nice long one, about a 20 to 25-yarder for the East, but it was not a scoring play, but it's been mostly on the air.
Just to recap for you, if you joined us late, the East squad did recover the opening kickoff. Excuse me, the West squad rather recovered it, and 3 plays later, Donegan went in on an 11-yard touchdown pass, number 24 Donegan, make it 7-0. Then the East returned the favor as Aaron Monday was on the receiving end of a 5-yard pass from Knight to make it 7-6 as the East missed the extra point. Then the West retaliated with that 56-yard run by Garner. Charlie Garner out of Jeb Stuart High School, and that made it 14-6 as the extra point was good. And then with just 2 seconds remaining, Darnell White kicked a 37-yard field goal, and the score at halftime with that field goal is 17-6 in favor of the West squad. They are trying to break a 2-game winning streak by the East squad. I don't know if we ever got a chance to actually name the Peninsula players that were involved here tonight, but are certainly the Peninsula area. Smithfield High School, Andre Savage, of course, from there. Maury High School is represented by Sean Knight. Hampton High School has Ryan Gerzak and Dwayne Murphy as well as Aaron Monday representing them. Of course, the Hampton Crabbers were state's runner-up last year. Excuse me, not last year, but the basketball team was, but the football team lost in the early rounds to First Colonial last year, and I understand they're out to revenge that. They have a scrimmage.
They're looking forward to that scrimmage. Lanny Franklin was up here during halftime, and he said that's our first scrimmage, so they're looking forward to that, I'm sure.
I guarantee you there'll be some head knocking in that scrimmage. Lanny not as optimistic about Hampton's possible success this year as in years past, but you never know. We do have some statistics, so we thank the fine folks here at City Stadium. Let me run these down if I...
Wow, nice job, Tim. I don't know how you do that.
I tell you, it's a miracle. The West squad with 17 points, 7 first downs, 18 rushes for 67 yards, 70 yards passing. Now, 3 out of 6, seemed like more than that. Total offense, 137. There you see the replay of the kickoff. One fumble, they did not lose it. They were not penalized at all, and they had the ball 11:45. I'll get back to the East.
Well, they were penalized. There was a personal foul, but it was like half the distance to the goal line on extra point on the touchdown pass to Monday. So I have to correct that. I remember that particular play.
You're absolutely right. West airs it out, and it's intercepted. On a fine effort by number 33 for the East squad, Donald Robinson of John Marshall High School.
Well, he played that ball real well, just stepped right in front. The offensive player had no chance to get it. What he should have done then is become the defensive player and try to stop the interception.
For the East squad in the first half, they had 7 first downs as well. They carried the ball 16 times for 38 yards, 71 yards passing, as you see the replay of the interception.
Now watch how he steps right in front and just, you can just catch it at the last minute, just out of your picture. Nice interception, though.
This is Murphy, and Murphy is met at the line of scrimmage and driven back, as that West squad has been keying on Dwayne Murphy all night long.
Well, he's not getting much blocking at that the point of contact, the line of scrimmage. The defense is winning it there, and that's basically why the offense has gone to the pass as they continue to rotate the quarterbacks in. Number 10 started Andre Savage, and then Sean Knight is now in for the East. So they're going to stay with the same thing they did in the first half, Tim.
Second down and 11 at the 36-yard line. Murphy lost about a yard on the play. And again, the West is there. The ball comes loose, and we've got a fumble recovery by the West. So that's the third fumble by the East squad and the second one that they've lost. Let me just finish these stats. The first half,
if you get a chance.
6 out of 9 for the East in passing for 109 yards. They punted twice for a 34.5-yard average. There you see as White, the ball just pops loose.
Well, he was still going forward. His forward progress was not stopped, so that was an excellent call by the officials.
Tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to give you those stats when we have a timeout. Back to the live action here. Darnell White is the quarterback. And a fumble on the exchange. White recovers his own fumble. Let me just finish these things up, if I may. The fumbles, 2 for the East. They lost 1. They were penalized once. And they had a ball 12-15. Murphy had 7 carries for 28 yards. The longest was 19 yards. In passing, Knight for the East, 4 out of 5 for 52. Savage, 2 out of 4 for 19. 1 TD for Knight, and he was sacked once. And receiving, Monday had 2 catches for 19 yards and a touchdown, the longest being 14. Branch had 2 catches for 33, the longest 19 yards. And Cully punted twice, averaging 35 yards a kick.
I don't know if you can see or not, Tim, but it is raining. It's a nice, it's a slight, just a slight rain, but it is going to make the ball a little slipperier.
And we're going to have a delay of game call against the West as they took too long with a 2nd down and 9. Now they're going to make it 2nd down and 14. On the individual leaders for the West squad, Garner in rushing had 5 carries for 67 yards. Of course, the 56-yarder taking the biggest chunk of that.
Dead ball foul, delay of game, offense, still 2nd.
All right, there you heard Ron Cherry, our referee, give you the call. Passing to Shazo, 2 out of 5 for 49 yards and a touchdown, sacked twice. White, 1 of 1 for 21. Pass receiving, Wright, Donegan, and Martin, each with 1. Now back to the action. White again goes long.
And that was a nice fake by the quarterback and an excellent pass. The defender was completely fooled. Nice catch by number 15.
Troy Raines. If our corrections are correct, might be Vincent Myers.
Well, Vincent Myers is a wideout. I know that. I don't know about Troy Raines. It's one of them. There's two 15s, and we got two 10s on the E squad, so. And they just took him right out of bounds at about the 1 foot line. We'll call it the 1 yard line.
Darnell White, quarterback. Inside handoff, we've got a touchdown. And that is Garner with the TD.
Well, the West picked up right where they started off. They turned the ball over deep in down around the 30-yard line and then got it right back on another turnover. So they really ended up in a great field position again. And they have had great field position just about all night long.
There you see the quick handoff to Garner in for the TD. Kind of on a long range shot there, but that's what happened. The kick is up and the kick is good. So the West now has blown this game open 24-6 with 8:52 remaining in the third. So even though the score is rather lopsided, the West squad leading by 24-6, the East squad has that explosiveness that you cannot count them out at this point.
Well, they're going to have to get a couple of turnovers. They have given a ball away twice, once at the 21 and one at about the 30, and you can't do that with a team that's got as good athletes as both of these teams have. Big number 55, Keith Burns, is getting ready to kick off. He's 200 pounds, 6'3", out of T.C. Williams.
The natural turf here at Lynchburg Stadium getting a little chewed up with the mist that is falling and the rain that we've had earlier this afternoon. And fortunately, it's not raining hard, so I'm sure the players enjoy this mist, kind of cool them off a little bit. Temperature in the 70s at game time. As fortunately for this game, a cold front has gone through. Burns shanks it to the left, and it stays in bounds, fielded at the 3 yard line. Leslie Hamlet out to the 25 before he's driven back.
Well, he got that ball at about the 1 or 2 yard line. I think he first thought maybe it might go into the end zone, but with this grass and turf as soft as it is, the ball did not respond well after it bounced.
Here you see the replay. This is Leslie Hamlet. Oof, was he ever met and driven back by Anthony Merchant.
We've called his name a few times tonight.
He's done a fine job. He had a defensive effort on Aaron Monday in the first half that prevented what could have been a big gainer for the East. And we have an official's timeout. And Ron Cherry signals we're set to go, and we'll crank it up with 8:25 remaining here in the third quarter. The West squad on top 24-6, 19th annual All-Star game from Lynchburg, Virginia. Inside handoff. Got some running room. This is Jerry German, and he's out across the 45-yard line for a first down.
Well, that's the first time that quarterback or that counter play really worked, but it worked to perfection that time. They started from about the 25. That's about a 21 yarder. Looks like about 21 yards on that play, Tim.
It was bottled up momentarily, but German did a good job of maintaining his balance. Got some nice moves there, got some good downfield blocking, and then it did a little extra on his own there before he was finally driven out of bounds. This is German again as he is on the move inside the West Territory down to the 41-yard line. And let's do a little checking up on some information about this young Jerry German.
Well, he is sure running well there. The East is starting to open up some holes. You thought that they might put the ball in the air, being behind as much as they are, but no way.
He is headed for Northeastern Oklahoma A&M. JJ, as he is known, has been selected the All-District, All-State, All-Region, and All-Metro. And he wants to be a professional artist. He right now is doing a fine job artistically carrying the football. Sean Knight trying to get a little running room on the far side is finally driven out after maybe a short game.
I think he went out of bounds before he got any yardage. He may have got back to the line of scrimmage.
Looks like they're going to credit him with about a yard, so let's call it second down and nine. He earned every bit of that yard.
Yeah, he did that. That was a hard yard to come by.
39-yard line is where the ball is placed in west territory. East trailing 24-6. On the delay to Murphy, and Murphy struggles for maybe another yard. Dwayne Murphy from Hampton High School.
Well, neither team has had very much luck right up the middle, and that was a second and long, which brings up and out a third and seven. And again, they try to go up the middle. This is definitely a passing situation. We got Aaron Mundy coming right to the right at the bottom part of your screen.
Andre Savage, the quarterback, stops, throws, and we've got a lot of contact downfield, but no call as Leslie Hamlet was trying to get a call. Said that he was shoved and pushed, but...
Well, that was incidental contact.
But we do have a flag down at the 40-yard line. Ron Cherry discussing it with one of the other officials. And we'll listen in, and Ron Cherry will tell us what the infraction was. They got an illegal shift against the East squad. So they will be looking at a fourth down and seven. Or a third down and 12. Here you see the replay.
Penalty is for illegal motion. Offense, penalty is refused. We're going to work fourth down.
Well, what happened that time was Aaron Mundy was not up on the line of scrimmage, and he moved up, and he's got to be set for a full second, and he was not set for a full second before the ball was snapped.
So the East squad now, fourth and seven, and they are not kicking. Monday is wide to the right. Savage, the quarterback, has a man open off the fingertips of the intended receiver, Leslie Hamlet.
Well, it was actually tapped by number 41 on the West squad, is the one at Merchant, Anthony Merchant again out of Lexington. He's the one that tapped the ball, or it would have been caught.
So Merchant now has been in on two good defensive efforts. Earlier he did a good job of busting up a reception to Monday. This time you'll see the ball in the air here, and it's going to be tipped. There you saw it, exactly.
Merchant. Had he not tipped the ball, that ball would have been caught. And the linebacker did a good job. He dropped back in his press, his zone coverage, and took away that pass.
So the West takes over on downs at their 37-yard line. 5:55 remaining here in the third quarter. A little bit of running room across the 40 to the 42-yard line, and that is Keith Hall out of Powell Valley.
Well, he picked up about 6 or 7 yards, and a lot of it was after he was hit. Well, not a lot of it, at least a couple, 3 yards of it was anyway.
Marked the ball just short of the 43-yard line. Here's the replay. Look at here, he does a nice job of getting away from one would-be tackler and then just drives forward. So that's the kind of thing these coaches are looking for, is that type of determination.
Well, that picks you up another yard or two by falling forward rather than backward, so you keep your feet moving all the time.
Second down and a long five for the West. Quarterback is DeShazo, and he gives off to Ziegler, and the big Ziegler is knocked to the ground instantly.
But that was Manson Clark. Did a great job. He's 6'2", 270 from Rustburg High School. Man, he met him at the line of scrimmage and straightened him up.
That's a lot of beef on that one. Woo. Ziegler is 5'11", 240.
So it was beef meeting beef.
Yeah, it was. Beef won.
You don't ask, where's the beef on that one?
No. 4:40 remaining in the third quarter. Ball is marked at the 43-yard line. It's third down and 5 for the West. Hope you're enjoying the ball game here on Channel 5, WHCS. Your home for Peninsula High School sports. And we've got a flag now, apparently a delay of game. And that's what the call will be. So the West squad will look at a third down and 11 now.
Dead ball foul. Delay of game. Offense.
Well, they only marked that back as third and about 9. He took short steps or took one too few. I'm not sure.
You're right. Yard marker is still inside the 10. Well, anyway. Got to stretch those chains every now and then. DeShazo still has the football. He's got red jerseys chasing him. A flag is down as he throws it away.
And that's got to be offensive illegal use of the hands, I'm sure, from where that flag was thrown. And that'll bring up a fourth down. They may just, well, I don't know if it's a 15-yarder. If you're the East, you want to take them, drive them back as far as they can go. And maybe you can get a turnover.
Illegal hands, offense, penalty declined, 4.
So the West squad was guilty of the illegal use of the hands, and the East squad did in fact decline the penalty, which of course they could have set up a third down again. I guess they just didn't want to give them another.
Well,
down.
It depends on where, if it's marked off at the point of the foul or where the snap of the ball. If it was at the point of the foul, I would have taken it because that would have moved them back inside the 20. And now they're at the 30, you're looking at about 38. That's about an 18-yarder, 20-yarder there. That would have been a, of course, I'm up here in the press box too.
Deep punt formation, good high kick, not particularly long. And it takes a West bounce.
And that's the first time the West has punted this in this game.
The ball rolls dead at the 34-yard line for the East, and they'll have the first and 10, trailing 24-6 with 4:04 remaining here in the third quarter. Only one score in the second half. That a 1-yard touchdown plunge by Garner, his second touchdown of the ball game, making the score 24-6 as it was 17-6 at halftime in favor of the West. Sean Knight, number 11, is the quarterback. Inside double handoff, and stumbling forward for a few was Brian Cully. Cully out of Cortland High School.
Well, that was a reverse.
Yep. Gave it to the man going to his left, who in turn handed it off to the man going to his right. Get a chance to watch it again. Executed it quite well. See the first handoff, then on the inside handoff, Brian Cully just tripped up or he would have gotten some good yardage. Pickup of 8 as it was, second down and 2 for the East. And again, the...
That's Dwayne Murphy on the handoff right up the middle, and he is running into a lot of stiff opposition.
As I started to say, the ever-present shuffling of the quarterbacks finds Andre Savage handing the ball off to Murphy.
I'm glad you're keeping up with the quarterbacks. I have a hard enough time trying to pick up the numbers of everybody else.
They mark the ball short of the first down. It's going to be third down and about a yard. 2:40 remaining in third quarter. The rain apparently has stopped, or certainly has become very minimal. For that, we are thankful. And nothing happening as right standing right there was Chip Ferguson, another name we've called a couple of times for the West squad. He was standing there and said, come on, Andre, I'm waiting for you.
Well, that was a naked bootleg, and he was definitely waiting for him. There was no blocker in front of him. That brings up a fourth down. I'm kind of surprised at some of the play calling on the East squad. They have some excellent receivers, and both of the quarterbacks can throw the ball well.
Rather conservative effort here in the third quarter with time running down at 1:40.
Well, and you're behind 18 points. You know you're going to have to score three times.
Not a particularly good kick. It is going to roll inside the 30-yard line as we've got some struggles going on downfield. A little boys will be boys action. Nobody hurt, no farm. No harm, no foul. Looked like number 75 for the East squad, Ricky Carter, was wrestling two West opponents and one. I would say he got a takedown on one and maybe a pin on the other. Minute 21 remaining here in the third quarter as the West squad gets the ball back now, leading 24-6. The West and the East knotted up in this series, nine victories apiece. And the winner of this game will take over the lead in the series, as well as be the victor for the week as far as the five different team competitions between East and West. And the ball pops loose. I believe the West has recovered. So the ball a little slippery as the grass has definitely some moisture on it.
Well, you know, I've seen that more at the exchange of the center and a quarterback rather than when they throw a pass. The wideouts seem to have glue on their hands because that ball is not slippery to the pass receivers.
Well, we also want to make point that these quarterbacks are not working with their regular centers.
Well, that's a good point.
These young men have been together since the 5th of July, I'm told, and they have been working on two-a-day practices. Lanny Franklin was kind enough to give us some information. Worked 2 hours in the morning and 2 hours in the afternoon since the 5th of July, so that's not a long time for these fellows to work together. And I think, overall speaking, the game has been played very well, considering the length of time that these two squads have had together.
And down at the bottom of that pile on defense that time was number 81, Ryan Gerzak, as the third quarter comes to an end.
So the only score was Garner's one-yard plunge, his second scoring touchdown of the ballgame. And the West squad now leading 24-6 as we'll start the final 12 minutes of play from Lynchburg Stadium, City Stadium here. Beautiful facility. The Lynchburg Red Sox of the Carolina League have a facility right behind this, and they, of course, play against the Peninsula Pilots and the other members of the Carolina League.
That's the facility that the baseball game was played in, and of course, I would like to mention Andy Shattuck for Kickatan High School. He's the one that made the hit that drove in. Well, actually, it wasn't a hit. It was a fielder's choice, but he's the one that made contact with the ball to bring in the winning run for the East squad in the ball game that was played here last night. I had talked to Buddy Denton earlier in the week, and he told me he was coming up because Andy was playing, and it's always nice to see one of your ball players do well in the All-Star game. Congratulations, Andy. He hasn't decided where he's going to go yet. He may either go to the apprentice school or Christopher Newport. That was the two choices that I had in the paper, but he's a fine young baseball player.
So the officials have reset the ball now to start the fourth quarter. It'll be third down and 10 for the West. Ball is marked squarely on the 30-yard line in West territory. Darnell White is the quarterback for the West. Jeb Stuart High School.
And there's a fumble. That time it popped straight up in the air, and the East did recover.
So the East gets a break here. It was going to be a fourth down even if they had not recovered, but now they'll get the ball in West territory at the 30-yard line.
And that was number 75, Ricky Carter, 6'3", 225 out of Sussex Central, that jumped on that ball, and right on top of him to help keep the ball down was our buddy Brian Gerzak.
There you see the replay.
I'm sorry, that's number 55 on top of him. Making sure that ball, and that's the young man from York High School, Jeff Edmondson. Edmondson.
Edmondson, yeah, that's what I was trying to say earlier. I was having a hard time putting the right emphasis on it. There you saw a pass on the right side completed to number 40, Chris Owens. Pickup of about six on the play. Second down and four for the East. There you saw the quick flare out. Hit immediately by, you guessed it.
Must be Merchant.
Must be Anthony Merchant. Throwing deep in the corner. Touchdown!
Aaron Mundy. Well, if you're the East, you got to go for two, Tim. That would get you back at down only 10, so you could tie the game at it with a touchdown and a field goal. So you've got to go for two. You've got to score two more times anyway.
Andre Savage unloaded that pass to Aaron Mundy in full flight, 25 yards, and Mundy with his second touchdown of the evening. So Mundy now has caught one for five and one for 25. And we'll see if, in fact, the East does go for the two.
And you can see that ball was right in a nice concentration by Aaron right over his shoulder.
Saw that for many years at Hampton High School. Now timeout as the East squad is going to go for two. Sean Knight stepped up to the line of scrimmage and then didn't like the defensive alignment and called a timeout.
Well, he had too many men on the field. Aaron Mundy was trying to run off, and he would not have been off in time. And the coach wants him in, so he comes back on the field. It replaces William Dyson start. I'm sorry, no, that's he's... That's Timmy Bland he replaces, number 80.
So still a lot of time remaining, a 12-point difference. And as you said, Bob, if the East squad can get a two-point conversion here, they'll only be down by 10.
So if they miss, they got to score two. They can score two touchdowns, and then they're right back in the game. So, the odds are you go for the two, and then that only puts you down 10. A lot of things can happen in 11 minutes.
So the East squad now will again, as you mentioned, go for the two. Quarterback for the East this time is Sean Knight. He rolls to his right. Gets a lot of pressure, and he will not have a chance to get it off. As over there on an excellent defensive effort was number
64. And what's his name?
That's Bill Swarm.
I don't have him. You got him.
We made that change. I heard that as the PA in Atlanta. He got us a lot of the changes, but that was one we didn't get from him, but I picked up off the PA. And that is Bill Swarm of GC Marshall High School. So the West squad is able to hold on the extra point try with 10:59 remaining in the third. Excuse me, the fourth quarter.
We're affecting the 9-point differential. The East will receive.
Okay, now I was wondering, I thought we had seen that before.
Yes.
If there's a greater difference in the score than 9 points, then the East can elect to receive the ball. So it makes it a little more interesting here. Now the East, having just scored, will be allowed to get the ball back. I like that.
I do too.
The college All-Star game used to be like that whenever they played against the pros. They used to have the East-West game, not the pros rather, but the colleges themselves, East-West Shrine game. If it was more than 10 points, then
right.
the team that was trailing had the election of receiving, even if they had just scored. Picked up at the 10-yard line. Leslie Hamlin has been a busy man this evening receiving kickoffs.
He has that.
So the East will get the ball back with 10:49 remaining, and they'll have it at their 28-yard line, trailing by 12 points. We appreciate it. Now, the fans here in the stands did not hear what we heard from Ron Cherry.
Yeah.
So that's kind of nice for you fans at home, because otherwise you and I would be looking at each other and saying, how come they got that ball back?
Well, one of us might have figured it out.
Yeah. Eventually we might have, but it was nice of Mr. Cherry to inform us of that and keep us informed of what's going on here. Passes incomplete. Intercepted.
That was an excellent interception by number 35 on the West. That's James Quander out of West Potomac. But, boy, he did a great job of getting to that ball and concentrating, getting his hands underneath it.
That was a great job. Because
well, the ball was intended for number 80, Timmy Bland, and it went right off his hands. And it looked like it was going to fall incompleted right there. But look at the concentration here. Oh, great job, Joe Lewis. Slow-mo Joe. Yeah, we got to talk about Jerome up there on the – he's up in the rain. But he's doing a good job on the camera. As always, we have excellent crew. Jerome Young up there. Is it wet up there, Jerome? It's dry down here.
Don't antagonize him.
Tim told me to say that.
The umbrellas have popped back up as the rain has resumed ever so lightly. More of a mist than a rain. But that interception, a superb job by Quander, and the turnover gives the ball back to the West at midfield. Pick up a five on the last play, second down and five. Inside of 9.5 minutes to go. DeShazo is the quarterback, pitches on the quarterback option. And close to a first down will be Keith Hall from Powell Valley.
Well, there's some solid hitting going on out there.
All these young men are winners. There's no losers in this game. All these guys are all-star selections. They were outstanding players in their districts, and they marked the ball well short of the first down. So I wondered where they'd mark it, and it is, in fact, a yard shy.
He may have gone out of bounds at that point.
What I started to say was all these players are first-rate players. They are all-stars in every right. And you're going to see a superb effort right down to the final gun. Even trailing by 12, you're not going to see the E squad give up, that's for sure. 8:39 remaining in the fourth quarter. DeShazo keeps, pitches, same play this side. And this time it works for the first down, as driven out of bounds at the 39-yard line is once again Keith Hall. And that play didn't work for the first down the time before, so they tried it to the near side.
That was Andrew Bell, number 32, in on the stop. He did a great job getting over there, but not until after the first down was picked up.
Here's a replay. Great camera work from the ground level there, and then slow-mo switches over for the high camera, and you'll see Hall.
And that's number 15. It just gets a hold of him as number 35 comes in there. And Cedric Gales. Number 15 for the East.
Again, Hall gets the call.
And you see what the strategy of the West is to run the ball and hopefully to pick up yardage and maybe a first down or two to run off the clock a little bit and put a lot of pressure on the East squad.
8 minutes and 4 seconds remaining in the fourth quarter. Ball is at the East 35-yard line.
You like those shorts? You can't see him, wrong leg.
You don't want to show those knees. This is Ziegler, and he picks up the first down inside the 25 to the 21-yard line.
Well, that young man is big. He's 240, 5'11". Oh, wow. What a hard man he is to bring down. He's got such a low center of gravity. You got to get him around the ankles. You're not going to bring him down. Watch this replay. Hit, spin, look at him, but run over the official.
First down for the West as they drive now with the clock moving with 7:30 remaining. DeShazo is the quarterback. Ball is at the East 21-yard line. DeShazo still has it, throws, has a man open, and is off his fingertips. The intended receiver on the play was Tracy Donegan. And he just couldn't hold on to it.
That ball hit him right in the hands.
Well, you can see there, if you can, the rain is heavier than it has been now. If you have a dark background there, Mr. Director, you can see that much better the rain.
And here we can see the replay.
Rain in slow-mo. Slow-mo will give us some rain here. There you see the pad right on the mark. It just slipped off his fingertips. One of those things. Clock stops with 7:17 remaining in the fourth. Second down and 10 for the West. DeShazo, and he just throws the ball out, and they're going to say no play.
Well, he was down. His knee was down before he pitched the ball, and that was exactly what Ron Cherry's crew were doing. They were waving that thing off.
Very dangerous play, actually. Because,
if you're the West coach, is saying, hey, wait a minute now. We don't need to do anything silly here.
You got to watch his knee now. He's going to be tackled here. He's going to spin. His knee is down. And just as it hits, he tosses it. And it would have been a precarious play, to say the least.
Well, if you had been in E-Squad and picked that up, you would have said, no, his That's knee right. hadn't hit yet.
Third down and 10. DeShazo steps up, gets away from a would-be tackler, and now he's going to race for the corner. He's going for the flag. He's going to come up short of the end zone, but he'll have a big first down for the West squad. And we'll return to City Stadium after this brief timeout. First down and goal for the West squad. DeShazo driven out of bounds at the one-yard line. It is a first down for the West as they lead by 12. And Keith Hall gets the call. He's in for the touchdown.
Right up the middle.
So now the West takes a 30-12 lead with 6:56 remaining in the fourth quarter. This is going to be the running play, I'm assuming. Let's see, this is the run or the pass?
No, this is the run where he fakes the pass and then brings it down and just outruns a couple of would-be tacklers there, cuts to his left, and there you can see just outruns Brian Gerzak and makes it right just down to about the one-yard line and where he's run out of bounds.
He just almost got to the flag there, but he just came up short. And while we were watching that replay, the extra point conversion is good. And now with 6:56 remaining in the fourth, the West has taken a commanding 31-12 lead. And the East squad has cut out for them now. So the turnovers really have hurt the East squad.
They really have.
Their opening kickoff over, and then they just have had a couple of, in the second half here, they had a turnover early, and then the West squad has capitalized.
Well, and it seems like if you go back and look at the game since the beginning, once they got that first turnover, they being the West team, they have not had bad field position. They got good field position then, and every time they've had the ball, they've seemed to have had great field position. Even when they ran the ball back from the kick, they ended up with decent field position. So they've been right on their game tonight and have really taken it to the East squad. Keith Burns is getting a lot of work out kicking the ball tonight.
Last minute substitution for the East squad as the coaches get two receivers back. Back deep is number 20, Jerry German. Picked up again by Hamlet, Leslie Hamlet. And he's been a workhorse all night. He returns the ball to the 31-yard line. As is East trailing 31-12 as they have never led this ball game. The closest they were was 7-6. Then it was 14-6, 17-6, 24-6. Then they scored a touchdown. Monday has scored the two touchdowns for the East squad. Aaron Monday from Hampton High School. They'll start from the 30-yard line. Pass in the flats there, intended for Kenneth Smith. And he may have heard footsteps.
You took the words right out of my mouth. He went up for the ball, but he was not concentrating on the ball that time.
That's one of those dangerous passes like you.
Oh.
You just, Andre Savage, there you see him going back, lofting that ball out there. There you see him, and he's up in that very vulnerable position. There you see Merchant, who is a real headhunter anyway.
Well, Larry Merchant's, not Larry, I'm thinking of the guy that's on
HBO.
Tony
Merchant.
Yeah. This young man has done a great job tonight.
Ryan Cully in motion. Sean Knight throws too long, almost intercepted. Monday took his man out.
Well, that ball was intended for Monday, but it was way over his head, and he made sure his man didn't intercept it. And that's what you got to do, and we can see this on the replay. Monday says, no way you're going to catch it.
No, look at that. He just drove his man in. Monday had to fall. He figured he might as well fall on somebody.
A little frustration, too. He scored all the points for the East.
.617 remaining. Knight's pass over the middle for Kenneth Smith. Still can't connect.
Well, that was Chip Ferguson, number 40, came up and played real tight on him, played almost like a bump and run, and kind of took his timing away from him. The West had a feeling where that ball was going to go.
So 6:10 remain here in the fourth quarter. Now the East squad looking at a 4th and 10 will be in deep punt formation. From his 20-yard line, the kick from Andre Savage takes an East roll out of bounds at the 42-yard line. Again, Ricky Carter, number 75, tangling with a couple of the West.
Oh, they're just, asking how each other's doing, what they're going to do after the game, and what your plans are for the rest of the summer. Just exchanging some pleasantries.
So the West now will try and wear the clock out as there are 6 minutes and 1 second remaining. Side handoff goes to Felix Edo. As the quarterback of record this series will be Darnell White, as the blue-clad West squad has consistently changed quarterbacks on each series. I mentioned earlier, the East squad has alternated quarterbacks on plays. We want to thank the fine folks here at Lynchburg Stadium, Lynchburg City Stadium, for all of their help with our crew setting up. As usual, we always receive the greatest assistance wherever we go. We appreciate that. And we see, again, same kind of play. Wear some time off the clock. Ball carry again, Felix Addo. We want to thank our crew for their usual superb job. Our director, Scotty Bowers, Slow-Mo Joe on the instant replay machine.
I got young Sam Still behind you. I say young, I'd say that with tongue in cheek.
Dr. Young Sam Still. And of course, we welcome Dory to our crew for this game, a young lady working with the graphics. And our camera people doing a great job as always. Jerome Young, others, their names of which I don't have in front of me, but I'll make sure I get them for you.
Well, we got a flag, which probably will be offensive holding or illegal use of the hands, and that's exactly what Ron Cherry is calling.
Mr. Director, can you give me the names of the other camera people? We got some people I'm not totally familiar with. Yeah, Jerome Young we got. Ron. Melvin Hooker and Ron Beeman.
Want to thank Irving Hudson for
holding
his help here.
Offense. Penalty is refused. Fourth down.
Irving Hudson here at the stadium has helped us considerably. We appreciate his efforts also.
Todd Summer, let's not forget
him. Oh, Todd, yeah, he wanted to take over my job, and then he thought he'd take over your job, and we got him down there on the sideline.
As soon as we found out who he wanted to be, we got rid of him. we mentioned Dory. Yeah. What's Dory's last name, Scotty?
Well, how about the other two camera people?
Lempinski, okay.
Lempinski, okay.
Dory Lempinski. That's easy to pronounce. Oh, the kick was a beautiful off and corner kick.
When things are going right for you, they just continue to go right.
What a
wow.
Kick. 4 minutes remaining. The ball goes out of bounds at the 2-yard line as the kick was placed perfectly by the West. That ball almost hit the East receiver. He was going to make a catch on it and then realized the wind got underneath that ball a little bit, I think, because it is going from our left to our right. And it just carried it over his head, and then he said, well, I'll let it go.
Well, the ball has kind of been hitting and just kind of dying as it hits the turf, but that hit right on the end and just took a spin and thought, well, he said, maybe he'll go in the end zone. And then it goes out of bounds just short of the end zone.
Throwing long and out of bounds. Andre Savage in his own end zone, unloaded. Clock stops with 3:51 remaining.
David Hooker and Ron Baton are the other two camera people. We will make sure we get their names in there. They're doing a great job.
Second down and 10 from the 2-yard line. The East trailing 31-12 and deep in their own territory. There you see the story. Savage roaming around in the end zone. Now he steps out and he'll have to carry the ball as he's across the line of scrimmage.
Well, we have a flag in the end zone, which could very well be offensive illegal use of the hands on the offense.
That's what it is, a holding call against the offense. Mr. Ron Cherry, our referee, indicates the call.
Holding, offense, we got a safety. He fouls in the end.
That's interesting.
Yeah, the infraction happened in the end zone, which could have been, if it had not happened, it would have been a tackle. But Ron Cherry's gonna come over and talk to the West coach.
So the infraction, the holding call, apparently, if it occurs in the end zone, then a safety is called, even though the quarterback was never tackled in the end zone. The safety is called. And of course, on a safety, it'll be a free kick for the East squad as they'll kick it from their 20.
Well, now what's going to happen is the West is going to kick.
The West will kick. I'm sitting here cutting myself off. Because right. They'll be ahead for more than 9 points. I had my knee holding down my cough button here. If I sounded a little weird there for a minute.
So the rules keep getting involved here as.
Yeah, there's a good picture of Todd Summer.
Normally the.
He wants to take over AG's place, your place, and my place.
Normally, after safety, the team scored upon would kick a free kick from the 20. But because of the All-Star rules, when a team is trailing by more than 9 points, after any score, they get to receive. So you wave off the free kick. The East squad loses 2 more points to the board. And now they trail 33-12 with 3:41.
That's only 3 touchdowns.
Yeah. 1 per minute.
There you go.
As you mentioned earlier, Mr. Burns, a busy kicking player this evening, will tee it up again. He'll have the wind with him. This one will go in and through the end zone. So the touchback will bring the ball out. And the East squad will take their last gasps. The West squad has led from the beginning. So many times you see a team create have a fumble early in the ball game, and it'll just set the tone for the whole game.
And early in the ball game, that check the first play of the game. That was when that happened.
This Andre Savage steps up and then is taken down after picking up 6 or 7 yards. Of course, the East needs a lot more than that, but the West is, of course, going to give them the short pass. They don't mind giving up even as many as 10, 15 yards, because that's not going to hurt you. But they're in kind of a prevent defense.
Well, that's the strategy. You just don't give up the long one. You let them have short ones, but not the long one. Here's slow-mo on the instant replay. Great camera work, fellas.
Inside of 3 minutes to go. Savage throws, and it's completed at the 45-yard line. Heavy-duty hit put on the receiver by number 33, Keith Lyle. But the East does, in fact, pick up the first down as Jerry German pays the price.
Well, he did a good job of concentrating that ball. He knew he was going to get hit, but he made sure he caught the ball. That was the primary thing he wanted to do.
You see it, and then German just as the ball gets there.
That was great timing by that defensive back.
Andre Savage, the quarterback, going to unload. He's got double coverage downfield, and it looks like it might be picked off. It is.
And number 30. Number 33, Keith Lyle for the West, is the one to come up with that ball. I wonder why it sounds so funny here.
Quit leaning on your cough button. So the West takes over in what has been an incredibly long fourth quarter, I have to tell you. Both teams have gone back and forth, back and forth. Here's your replay. Savage unloads, throws long into double coverage. Just a Hail Mary pass at best. Flag goes down. So just what you wanted, a stoppage of play with 1:51 remaining.
You're East, you want to get it over with, but I believe that is an infraction against the West. We will hear from Ron Cherry. His crew has done an excellent job out here tonight, and as they did last year. We're very fortunate to have a crew that does as well as they do.
Holding. Offense. We put down.
So the call goes against the West. Rather immaterial at this point as the crowd starts to file out. And the West continues to have possession of the ball with 1:48. So look at Reuben Brown after a long night at the football field. 61 for the West squad. Minute 34 remaining. Pitch out near side. Garner is tackled for a loss. Garner's had a fine evening. He's got two touchdowns for the West squad.
And the East calls timeout with 1:22 to go. They're just prolonging your agony.
Garner with a 56-yarder and a 1-yarder tonight. Garner and Monday, each with two touchdowns for their teams tonight. .22 remaining, 33-12. The East squad not giving up, not till the last second is over with. Just noticing Andrew Harvey, number 66 for the East, 6'4", 252. Wouldn't want to meet him in a dark alley.
I'll tell you, there's some big young men out there. I was talking to Gannon Baker prior to the interview. We was looking at the ball players. I said, there's some big players. He says, they were big without the pads on. He said, you put the pads on, they really look big.
There's a big one there, number 72.
And that's his little brother next to him.
Is that right?
I think they're related to Scotty.
I'll tell you one thing. I wouldn't want to have the food bill here.
No way.
There's some beef on that field. Don't you imagine these guys, since the 5th of July, they have chewed up some food out of this facility here. I believe they stay over at Liberty Baptist College, don't they?
Yes.
DeShazo chased around and finally sacked inside the 10 at about the 6. The East is either out of timeouts or realizes the futility of calling another one. It's going to be fourth down, and we're going to be inside of a minute to go now.
I believe it was third down, 10 and 28. They were penalized once, so they got that down over.
You're absolutely right. I was just going to say, if they don't hurry, they'll be penalized one more time.
Well, that's the only mistakes that they have made tonight. I think it's three or four, but that's about the only thing that they have done tonight that has been consistently wrong.
Delay a football game, offense. Still third.
.34 seconds remaining. The West squad will break a 2-year losing streak here at Lynchburg. Lost the last 2 years, but they'll come away a victor tonight, and the West squad will win the overall championship for the week. 3-2 in the 5 different competitions that have taken place. Final timeout called by the East squad as they have decided to stop the clock with 27 seconds remaining.
Well, they got a punt, and the other team could have almost run out the clock lining up for the punt. So the East wants at least one more chance to put some score points on the scoreboard, Tim.
Fielded at the 40-yard line. The hitting continues downfield as returning the ball is 32 Andrew Bell. With 15 seconds remaining, the East will have one last gasp. for the East at the 22-yard line. Time to run a couple of plays. Savage throws it up for grabs, and the West intercepts. And that'll do it. With 7 seconds remaining, the West takes over on the interception. So the West has been defensively superior tonight.
Oh, they really have. That was just not a well-thrown pass. It was way out into the flat, and he just kind of, it was not a whole lot of zip on it, and there was two defenders out there, and they just played the ball. They had a beat on the ball a lot better than the offensive player did.
So the West here will obviously, or at least I should hope, just
that's it. They ran out of time.
So they didn't even have to run over there.
No,
so
no time had to come off.
So
I'm sorry, they didn't have to call. The clock started as soon as they changed possessions. And you see that just kind of lobbed. The offensive man turned around, and there's the two defensive men. They were watching the ball from the get.
All right, that's going to do it from City Stadium in Lynchburg. The 19th annual Virginia High School Coaches Association All-Star Game has been won by the West squad. There you see the final score, 33-12. We've certainly enjoyed bringing this game to you. The third year in a row we've been up here in Lynchburg, and I personally have certainly enjoyed it. I hope you did, Bob, and I hope our fans enjoyed the game as well.
Well, I tell you, we kind of look forward to this. This kind of sets the tone for us. We get start getting anxious for the football season, which is only about 6 weeks away. And we appreciate Mike Smith and his crew and all those people that helped us up here on our crew, and is always does an excellent job. And you and I will look forward to the season starting in August.
August 31st, first game on WHCS Channel 5 will be the game played. August 31st, Friday night, Hampton will host Green Run at the new Darling Stadium. We hope to see you out there for the game. Come on out in person and then watch it on Channel 5, as we'll have a full slate of games during the high school football season. Final score again, the West squad 33, the East squad 12. For Bob Hintz, this is Tim Cole and the entire crew. Thanks for watching. Good night, everybody.